When you read about Mossad and everybody puts them out there as the top three spy agencies, you know, U.S.'s neighbors are Canada and Mexico, let's just say, right? Okay, we got Cuba over here, but let's just say U.S. and Canada and Mexico. You look at U.K.'s neighbors, they're kind of by themselves and they got a few neighbors over here. Your neighbors are Syria, Iraq, Lebanon, Saudi Arabia. There's always conflict going on. You're a small little nation. You're not big. You're very powerful. The reputation that's been built is, you know, is one of a kind. You know, some of them even call you, I don't know if you guys, you know, you like this reputation, professional assassins with a few boundaries and strike fear in opposing enemies. And you look at the culture and what it's known for, you know, bringing justice to those who have harmed the Jewish people, number one. Number two, neutralize military threats to the state of Israel. Number three, retaliate against the perpetrators of terror. Number four, help Jewish refugees reach the land of Israel. I mean, it's a very specific, you know, culture that you guys have, but I want to hear it from you. What do you think separates the culture of Mossad versus the MI6 or versus the CIA or any other agency out there?
There are quite a few topics which makes the Mossad unique as compared with our partners, the Americans and the Brits. For one, the Mossad is responsible of looking for the security of Jews in around the world, Jewish communities. Okay, one, two. The Mossad was responsible in order to bring Jewish people from the diaspora who lived in countries where they were persecuted by the local authorities. And I can name you a long history since the inception of the State of Israel and even before, that the Mossad, by executing all kinds of strange operations and activities, we brought the Jews from Iraq, we brought the Jews from Syria, we brought the Jews from Yemen, Ethiopia, Morocco, and we also brought Jews from Iran after the revolution. Since you are familiar with Iran, the way we did it, in very generally speaking, we used to move them from Iran to Pakistan, and from Pakistan to Europe, and from Europe to Israel. And quite a few Iranian Jews came by this way. So this is another distinction between the responsibilities of the Mossad and the other intelligence organization. Another topic is, in addition to provide the state of Israel and the government of Israel with intelligence, we at all times we have to try and identify signs and indications of peace with our present enemies. This is why the Mossad was involved very deeply with the peace process with Egypt, which was the first Arab country that signed a peace treaty with Israel. And the same goes for the peace between Israel and Jordan. The Mossad was instrumental and played a major role in these two pieces. And we are, as I mentioned, we are expected, and it is one of our jobs to try and identify indications and political changes in the region towards peace. Another mission of the Mossad that today does not exist anymore was to chase German or former Nazi Germans who were participating, took part in executing Jews during the Holocaust. So these are mainly the differences between us and the other intelligence organizations.
Shabtai, who trained you guys? Because when I read about the Savak, Savak was trained by CIA and the MI6, right? Who trained the Mossad originally?
Just let me add to what you just said about the training of the Savak, that in addition to the Americans and the Brits, Savak was trained by the Israelis as well. Now we were trained mainly by trial and error, because the Mossad was officially formed after the inception of the state, but before Israel was born, we had what was called the Haganah and Palmach and all kinds of military, quasi-military organizations that performed, that were acting in Israel and in the Middle East along the trail of independence, which was very lengthy. We learned by ourselves from experience.
So if you like this little short clip from an interview I did, click over here to watch the entire interview. And please don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.